Oh man, I just realized this video has the potential to piss off a lot of people. Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm not gonna do a story time. I decided that I'm not only going to tell stories but also share some thoughts and opinions about stuff that I find interesting or important, so I hope that's okay with you guys. I have a new setup, I have a new camera, hopefully the sound is better this time, so let's pray. First, I'm gonna tell you about the reasons why I went vegan. So the moment I decided to go vegan, I wasn't a vegetarian. I just ate meat, I ate everything I wanted, but I did care a lot about the world and what was going on inside of it. And it got even to the point that I felt bad about it. I felt bad that the environment wasn't doing well, that entire species were dying, that lakes were being poisoned, the barrier reef was dying. But not only about the environment, I also cared about people, about why people were suffering, people who were alone, people who were tortured, killed, abused. Everything just got to me on a very deep level, and it still does, but in that moment it felt like it really hurt, you know? Like it was personal for me. I had the feeling, I felt the pain of all those millions of people and animals at the same time, and sometimes that could be very heavy on me. The truth is, our food industry is really cruel. It's not a secret, it's a fact that if you eat regular meat, dairy, eggs, anything that's made by animals, there's probably a lot of suffering that it came out of. You know, there's cows that are being impregnated year after year after year after year after year, having their babies taken away from them just so they can make milk. Chickens that are being crammed in tiny little cages or in big spaces, you know, I don't know the name for that. Chickens are being crammed together. They give them a lot of antibiotics because otherwise they would almost all die, because the circumstances in which they live is so bad, you know? And that's just cows and chickens. Even bees sometimes are mistreated to get honey. You know, there's a lot of suffering that goes on in the food industry. And in many occasions, organic food is better, but not always. And still, even if the animal had a life on an organic farm and it was rather normal, sometimes they are being slaughtered in a regular slaughterhouse, and it's still really brutal and inhumane, you know? So I started realizing that the food industry was really cruel, and I didn't want to take a part in it anymore. I wanted to change something, so I went vegan. One day I was eating meat and dairy and everything, the next day, nothing. I was really extreme about it also. I had a lot of friends and at the time boyfriend that was also a veggie, and I would rather eat nothing than eat something that could possibly be contaminated. So sometimes I didn't eat for a day because I was out or with friends or something, and there wasn't a vegan option. This was many years ago. Nowadays there's more options for vegans, but then there was almost nothing. And it was just really hard to keep up with that. But also I was a student, so I didn't have a lot of money. I didn't have a lot of money to buy good food for me, you know. I was just trying to survive. And at times it became really difficult to stay true to veganism, but I managed to stay true to it for almost 2 years. Even though I had tons of negative critique from some of my family members, some of my friends who didn't understand, or I am part Mexican, so in Mexico eating meat is really important. There aren't that many people who are vegetarian. My mom was vegetarian, but I don't really know a lot of people that are. So I had to constantly battle, you know, battle for my right to be a vegan. And a part of me kind of enjoyed that. I was a rebel. I liked fighting for those things, but it was also really exhausting just to try explain to people why I was vegan and why I was doing all those things. I was a student, I didn't have a lot of money, and I didn't have the financial freedom to buy a lot of healthy stuff, you know, because even nowadays, eating healthy is really expensive, and that's really is a shame. Not only eating vegan or vegetarian, but just eating a lot of nuts, fruit, all healthy things, you know, are just really super expensive. And everything that's processed, has a bunch of sugar in it, all that stuff, is not. It's cheaper to eat unhealthy than to eat healthy. And I didn't have the means to feed myself properly, and it went on for a long time that I always ate the same things that weren't that expensive. I didn't really have a balanced diet, so for me it was really difficult. And at one point I started to have health problems, and I went to check my blood. And there were a lot of things that weren't really super in order. I wasn't super healthy. I was getting tired, and I decided to quit after almost being vegan for 2 years. That's out of my personal belief. It has nothing to do with other people telling me what to do. I just didn't feel like I had the energy to keep it up anymore. So until this day, I'm not vegan or vegetarian anymore. I try to just eat ethical. I try to eat as much organic as I can. Sometimes I eat meat, but the whole family tries to not eat too much. I also have 2 children, so it's really difficult to have separate diets because they already have a specific diet. They can't have gluten or dairy, and to combine that with vegetarianism or veganism is really difficult. There are many studies that suggest that animal protein is very important for children that are growing up. There are some studies that say otherwise, that if you do it correctly, there won't be a problem in their health and their growth. But I don't know, I don't feel like I should be the person that chooses this for them. I think if they want to do it when they're older, they want to go vegan, vegetarian, fruitarian, whatever, I don't care, they can do it, but by their own choice. Just like I don't really feel like I should obligate them to be religious, to be an atheist, to rely on science, or be a Wiccan, I don't know. Just, it's not my place to make that decision for them. I know that many parents do, and I understand, and it's a part of the upbringing, but me personally, I don't think I'm in a position to make that decision. So what really bothers me about some vegans, vegetarians, but also meat eaters, is that some people feel the need to tell you what to do, and they feel offended if you don't stand by their morals or their opinions. Some people know that I'm a really big fan of PewDiePie. I think he's really funny, makes great videos.
Also, he's really good looking.
And some time ago, he made a video about a vegan named Sorcha that was bashing on him because she thought that his channel and his message wasn't meaningful because he wasn't a vegan. And that's just madness for me. There's many different causes in the world to be fighting for. Veganism is one of them, but I think you should respect other people's life choices. You know, PewDiePie made a lot of money for charity, and it's like it doesn't even matter. It's like animals are the only thing that matter, and it doesn't. I think it doesn't. In my opinion, everyone is a hypocrite. You can be vegan, you can be super polluting, you can have a super polluting car, you're still doing harm to the planet. And animals aren't the only ones that need help. There are children who don't have a home. There are third world countries that are being exploited. There are even people in our more wealthy countries that are homeless, that are unhappy. Just so many things. I don't think it's possible to be 100% moral. Nobody is perfect. We're all just going along with the stream, you know, we're just trying to make it work, trying to do our best, and everybody has the right as a person that is living to try to find happiness, and the emphasis lies on different things for different people. That's what makes it so difficult for everyone to live on the same planet, because we're all so different. You may know, for example, Freely the Banana Girl, who was also a person that was driven by conflict and by hate and by reacting to other people, telling them they're fat. I know she changed now. She didn't want to do those kind of videos anymore, and I think that's really brave of her to admit that the things that she was doing weren't necessarily the most positive things. And that she changed her ways, you know, I think that takes a lot of courage. But I also have a lot of meat eaters that are offended when I, for example, post something on my social media about veganism or eating less meat. They get really personally offended. A response I get a lot of times is, "Oh, if you're not eating meat, well, more meat for me." Doesn't make any sense. The meat is being produced anyway, so I don't know what they're trying to say with that, but it's just, I don't know, a lot of people get like personally offended if you show your opinion about food. It's not only veganism, vegetarianism, all those things, it's also eating gluten-free. People get offended by that also, make fun of it, you know. If someone wants to eat the way they are eating, let them do it. It's their life. So for me, it's really difficult to try to be vegan again because some time ago I discovered that I can't really digest carbs and sugar that well. So I get really tired from eating all those things, and a vegan diet is high carb and almost no protein, and my diet is almost the opposite. It's really difficult. It's also really expensive, and I'm already struggling to make ends meet, so I don't think it's the right choice for me at the moment. Maybe in the future I'll change my mind, but I just try to eat organic when I can, and I'm just not blindsided for the horrors that take place in our food industry. You know, I know when I'm eating a piece of meat that an animal died for it. It's just the way it is, and I just try to respect that animal and understand where it came from. I also tell my children, if they ask me where does meat come from, I don't tell them all the gruesome details, but I tell them, yeah, an animal died for it. And I let them make their own decisions about it. They'll grow up and they'll make their own opinions about it. At first my children, they were shocked when I told them that meat came from animals, but now they understand. And I think it's really important that we don't lose connection with the source of our food, you know, not only the animals and the plants involved, but also the people making them, the people working for them, the people transporting them, just being more aware of our food and where it comes from. To end this video, I really don't want to bash on vegans, vegetarians, meat eaters. I think everyone should make their own choice, but this is mine and this is why I did it. So make sure to leave a like and subscribe to my channel. My other social media are linked at the end or in my bio, so take a look at those too, and I'll see you next time. Bye.